Doctor Who Stowaway by Jenny O'Connor.
How very extraordinary,
exclaimed the Doctor, anxiously peering at the flickering lights of his central console.
Do my calculations deceive me, or has the impossible happened?
He reached in his pocket for the reassuring crinkle of his jelly baby packet and pondered anew. Yes, the impossible had happened. The TARDIS had materialised in solid rock. The cause of this dilemma, as any trainee Time Lord could tell you, was due to a fault in the safety scanner. That delicate instrument, recently made compulsory by Gallifreyan law, was designed to stop time ships materialising in tricky situations. No TARDIS could be without one. Though the Doctor had to admit that his own had been on the blink for a few hundred years. When hadn't the TARDIS landed him in danger? The Doctor was now trapped, imprisoned beneath 600 feet of solid rock in the barren mountain ranges of the planet Neato. There seemed to be no escape. He dared not move his ship without first repairing the safety scanner. Why, the TARDIS might find any number of terrifying dangers in the unknown reaches of the universe. Yet, what the Doctor hadn't realised was that the TARDIS didn't have to go anywhere else to find danger. It was already trapped with him on board.
Oh, the infernal safety scanner!
Shouted the Doctor, throwing down his Gallifreyan sensor spanner. 5 hours entombed in a rock is enough to make anyone, even the Doctor, a little jumpy.
What we need is a nice cup of tea, right, K9?
With the sweep of the scarf, the Doctor hurried off in search of tea, unaware of the danger which lurked in the dark corridors of his ship. Green, pulsating, and totally evil. The being who now stalked the Doctor had arrived on board the TARDIS many centuries ago. It had simply been a spawn caught in the velvet jacket of the Doctor's first incarnation during a visit to the notorious planet of Sleimos. Lying in one of the countless forgotten rooms of the TARDIS, the alien seed began to grow. The green menace that now lurked within the TARDIS had only one instinct in its hideous, slimy body: to hunt down the living occupant of the ship and totally destroy him.
Now, where do I put that rather fine blend of Venusian tea, K9?
Right-hand shelf, Master.
Ah, yes.
The Doctor's mind was so preoccupied with the thoughts of tea and safety scanners that he failed to notice a sweet, sickly smell which wafted into the room. A stool toppled over, and the Doctor swung round to find himself face to face with the most horrific creature he had seen in years. Quite a shock when you're trapped 600 feet below solid rock. The Doctor stared in horror as the green, pulsating terror crawled slowly towards him. He could sense the creature's evil, its single-minded instinct to kill.
Run, K9!
Shouted the Doctor. The little computer dog did as his master commanded and bolted for the door. The Doctor knew that he was trapped. He had no weapons with which to fight this nameless horror or the possibility of escape. The creature lay waiting between him and the door. K9, hurriedly making a few rough calculations on the limited data at hand, realised that a quick burst of fire wouldn't go amiss. It might stun the creature long enough to save his master. The green, pulsating alien drew back in fear as K9's power beam scorched its side.
Ah, good show, little chap,
congratulated the Doctor as they raced back down the dimly lit corridors to the comparative safety of the central console room.
I really do wish houseguests would show a little more graciousness,
said the Doctor, as he began the task of barricading the door outside the corridor.
How are your batteries, K9?
Only 30% probability of repelling another attack, Master.
The Doctor was worried. to being tombed with a low-powered robot mutt and thoroughly nasty piece of green slime was no joke. In fact, for the first time in weeks, he couldn't think of anything even faintly funny. Biting the head off his fifth jelly baby, he smelt the now familiar sweet smell of decay. The creature was outside the door. Through a green, hazy mist, the contorting, slimy being saw the rough outlines of a door and knew his quarry to be on the other side.
Crush, Maria,
it thought.
Destroy the doctor!
Push, canine!
Puffed the exhausted Time Lord.
Harder!
He cried, feeling the door give way to the tremendous force that seethed on the other side. All hope collapsed with the door. As the doctor faced the green pulsating terror, he knew that this time there really was no escape. Light years away, in the steamy swamps of the planet Slimos, the ever-watchful Guardian of Good opened its mind to the battle of wills being fought among the stars. Telepathically attuned to the creature's single-minded instinct to kill, the Guardians had for centuries protected the planet's murky undergrowth from the green terror that lurked there. Yet never had this monster of creation travelled so far into space. The Guardian of Good realized that it must not be allowed to spread its evil spawn across the universe. Yet, was its mind strong enough to traverse such an immense distance? Could the green terror be stopped? A hideous scream pierced the tense silence aboard the TARDIS. The Guardian's penetrating thought waves brought the creature to a trembling heap of miserable agony. The green terror was soon helpless, and in no time at all, a large cage was formed to house the creature.
My word!
Cried the doctor, a little relieved as the bolt slid to.
K-9, do you have any data on what could have possibly happened to remind our unfriendly green guest of his manners?
But the little computer dog could hardly reply. The events of the last few hours had proved too much for him. And it wasn't a cup of tea that K-9 needed, Venusian or otherwise, as the doctor tried to suggest, but a set of newly recharged batteries.
That's it,
the doctor said happily, throwing down his Gallifreyan sensor spanner.
We're all fixed and ready to go.
Are you sure, Master?
Replied an uncertain K-9.
Databanks suggest a fitting description of job to be botched.
Botched?
Shouted the Doctor, horrified by his companion's unintentional insolence. But he chuckled to himself as the TARDIS began its next journey. Life was so much more exciting with a faulty safety scanner.
Yes.